are they spraying?
Those who fear chemtrails could be secret biological or chemical testing on the public point to the 1977 Senate hearings in particular, which confirmed 239 populated areas had been contaminated with biological agents between 1949 and 1969. Later, the 1994 Rockefeller Report concluded hundreds of thousands of military personnel were also subjected to secret biological experiments over the last 60 years. But could secret testing be underway yet again?
Cloud of dust, leaving a sticky yellow slime all over her car. It happened again last February, and calls began pouring into the local Alpenhorn newspaper.
And they had a tremendous upsurge of children that were not going to school at that time.
Could a strange substance found by a Southwest Arkansas man be part of a government test? Well, that's the question at the heart of a phenomenon called chemtrails, now getting widespread attention. Well, tonight, Baseline News 12 investigation reporter Jeff Farrell shows us the results of testing we had done about what's in our skies.
It seemed like some mornings it was just crisscrossing the whole sky. It was just like a giant checkerboard.
Bill Nichols snapped several photos of the strange clouds from his home in Stamps, Arkansas. They begin as normal contrails from a jet engine, but do not fade away like a normal contrail. Soon after, he saw particles in the air.
You know, because we'd see it drop to the ground in a haze.
Nichols then noticed the material collecting on the ground.
This is water and stuff that I collected in bowls. I had it set out in my backyard on my dad's pickup truck.
KSLA News 12 had the sample tested at a lab. The results? A high level of barium, 6.8 parts per million, more than three times the toxic level set by the EPA. Barium is a hallmark of other chemtrail testing, which even attracted attention from a Los Angeles TV station. There's already no shortage of unclassified weather modification programs by the government.
And you know, it turns out until 9 years ago, the government had the right under U.S. law to conduct secret testing on the American public under specific conditions. Only a public outcry repealed part of that law, with some exceptions.
Now, Jeff's report mentioned high levels of barium linked to those alleged chemtrails. We wanted to find out exactly what effects barium has on the body. We spoke with Mark Ryan, the director of the Poison Control Center. Ryan tells KSLA News 12 that short-term exposure can lead to anything from stomach to chest pains. Long-term exposure causes blood pressure problems. Ryan addressed concerns by chemtrail researchers that barium could be meant to wear down a person's immune system.
Anything that causes ill effects in the body long-term, chronically, is going to affect your ability because it's constantly working on the body. So from that aspect, yeah, that's a potential.
And what I found was unusual spiking since the early 1990s in barium, aluminum.
But Rosalind Peterson of California Skywatch says health department records show a sharp increase in both chemicals in the water supply of Northern California, dating from the time the huge contrails first appeared over her home in Mendocino County.
What's the significance of the barium and the aluminum?
I went and got all the tests, and all these things in the same test would be up way over state and federal standards. It had to be airborne. because how could it get to such diverse regions of our county? We have jets going in every direction. X's, east, west, north, south, circles. There is something going on in the air. I don't know exactly what, but I think there's some experimentation.
Is it legal?
I don't know, because we haven't had a public discussion.
But what is unknown today may be actual fact tomorrow, thanks to a bill soon to be voted on in the U.S. Senate, a Weather Modification Act, calling for research in, quote, attempting to change or control by artificial methods the natural development of atmospheric cloud forms.
Doesn't it seem to you that they're going to be doing it in the future for sure?
Yes. And if they are, I want to know about it.
In the meantime, a lot of people are wondering if they'll ever get clear skies. And a clear answer.
The legislation is there. Therefore, somebody's thinking about this. How does this make sense?
I don't know. Maybe they're practicing.
Over Cedar Glen. over Arrowhead.
I guess you have to try it out before you use it.
Last weather segment. This is inevitably military or something going on. The government, the Air Force, they send out what's known as chaff, and it's a way to experiment with the radar system. And when you see this kind of a pattern like this, can rest assured there's something going on. They're actually little bitty magnetic and little bitty strips of, whether it's aluminum, you know, they change it, but what happens is the radar deflects off of all these little pieces, and they use it actually as a jamming mechanism for radar in warfare, but it can also jam our radar and make rain appear that there really is no rain out there.